Okay, part two of the video. What I did is I put it back together. Actually had to take it apart or drop it back down because I found two ball bearings laying underneath of it. So make sure you have your balls in the tray, and when you go to seat the top part of the hub down, remember that grease on the inside of this top part here is sticky. And it might pull one and throw it on the floor somewhere. So if you have something white, like a white sheet or something like that to lay under it, it'd probably be better. So what I've did, I've got a screwdriver. I'm pretending it is the boom of an antenna, okay? And I know my north because, well, I've got a... I just know where my north is here from other arrays that I have. So I just took a long old rusty screwdriver and so she's showing what, 30 degrees. So let's see if she'll spin. She's coming around to the east right there. Well, you could just pretend it's an antenna. Coming up to the south. Coming up to the southwest. Coming up to the west, there, and coming around back north again, about there. So as you can see, it's about the place that it started. So let's take it on over to 45. 450. Let's make sure it stops. Okay. She stopped just shy of east. That is just about, that's east. Give or take a little bit. So let's bring her back. Bring it back and see. Good, past north, heading around to the west side. Notice I'm looking at the rotor. There's about west right there. Southwest. South, about right there. Coming up on the east, right about there. So there is a little difference there. Once she stops, she'll be at north. Okay. So, like, a little bit ahead of east, and a pretty good ways away from north. So, I mean, 30 degrees. It's pretty significant. This is the time that you want to go to your instruction manual and turn the rotor, mark the rotor while it's fully counterclockwise, let it rotate 360 degrees, mark it, and sorry about that, I got an indication there. mark it so you know it did a full north to north turn. Go ahead and mark that on your rotor and the bottom of your rotor. Then what I like to do is make an adjustment back here on your adjustment. So wherever it's at that 360 spot on here, just bring it over to north. And then continue to the 450 degrees. And that should put you over here if everything's working correctly. So now this is something that's going to bug me. Not that I work a lot in northern passes, but I mean, it's usable until I can get the, in 12 weeks until I can get the new, potentiometer in, but it's not like deal breaking. So, and again, it could be, I could adjust the housing on it too. Like I can lift it up and, maybe put it, since this is showing 30 degrees, make sure this lifted up, cock it a little bit toward the northeast, set it back down, and then bring my tray back up and bolt it down, which is what I'll probably do tomorrow, but I'm burnt out today. So that's a good way to tell you guys to, calibrate your potentiometer, clean it, try to clean it good, and just roll with it. Let me show you the cleaner I use here. CRC QD electronic cleaner. It's about $6 for, I don't know, 11 ounces, but I pretty much doused the pot. So I douse the pot in it and just let it dry, kind of wipe the outside part of it off, and there we go. So it's close, but no cigar, but it's at least it's working, ballpark. Hopefully the rest can be finished on the back panel adjustments here, the full scale adjustment. Thanks for watching, guys.